What do you believe is 100% true but can't prove? The management at my work have installed some sort of signal jamming Faraday cage around the toilets, so the staff can't spend time in the toilet using the internet on their phones. YouTube dislikes on comments do nothing. Companies like 23andMe will eventually sell customers' DNA to health insurance companies. And some folks will be charged higher rates, if not kicked off their insurance. Most of the long-winded top posts slash comments on Reddit are written by professional or aspiring writers who actually do not have the first-hand experience they claim to have. Gatorade switched to curvy bottles to hide that they are 4 ounces smaller. The US government runs VPN services to collect info on people who attempt to evade the NSA collection programs. That Brooks Brothers in the airport is a money laundering operation. I fly 2 or 3 times a month, and I almost never see any customers in those places at all, but somehow they manage to maintain prime airport storefronts. I'm 99% convinced that they only exist to launder money. Not getting enough sleep is the millennial fat-slathered burger. In a few decades, there'll be campaigns to get more sleep, just like there is non-smoking and healthy eating. And we will have studies on the lifespans of people who don't get enough sleep. Edit to everyone going, "No crap, Sherlock, if it were that obvious and commonly known, it wouldn't be so damn common to boast about how little sleep you get. Nobody boasts about how many cigars they smoke, because they know that crap is goddamn toxic. But even people who know that they should sleep better underestimate the havoc they are doing to their body, and the potential long-term damage this is doing to them. And they won't find out until it's already there. Much like a few generations ago, people didn't appreciate the toxicity of smoking until they already had cancer. My grandmother quit smoking decades ago and now has lung cancer. If you barely get any sleep in your teens, but sleep well in your 20s onwards, how much damage have you already done? Several people have already pointed out that extensive research has already been done on this. Great. So now we have to build public awareness and make this knowledge as common as the knowledge of the damage smoking can do. Make staying up late to be a workaholic as unappealing as smoking a pack a day, and just as uncool, rather than something to crow about. Also, for those who want to learn more, many commenters have suggested Matthew Walker. That 80% of adults genuinely have no idea what they're doing, and we're all just coasting. Subway was much higher quality 20 years ago. The US government artificially deflates the price of cheap high-calorie low-nutrition foods, because poor fat people don't overthrow governments, poor hungry ones do. That anything and everything we do on our mobile phones, even when you think you are being secretive by using invented usernames and arbitrary passwords, is being logged and electronically documented somewhere. Privacy is a thing of the past. Axioms. I'm actually the most attractive dude on earth and the Tinder mods are just jealous, so they hide my profile from everyone slash s. Vegesicles and oatmeal cream pies are smaller than they were when I was growing up in the 1980s. That in elementary school one day, when there was a substitute teacher, Jabron stole all my shiny football stickers from my drawer. The sub teacher didn't know any of the kids, and when the real teacher came back a few days later, they said there was nothing they could do as they weren't there. Jabron mysteriously had a lot more football stickers to trade at lunchtime. Frick you, Jabron. Aliens exist. There's definitely life somewhere else in the universe, or even in our own galaxy. Most internet providers are throttling your service, so you never reach the advertised speeds, except for speed checking websites, which, whilst not normally reaching your advertised speeds, are quick enough that you think it's just having a bad day. Elf on the Shelf. The elf doll that supposedly watches children and reports back to Santa, that parents love so much, is actually a subversive program by government or maybe corporate interests to desensitize children to being under constant surveillance so they won't question it as adults. No, I don't believe there are any cameras or mics in the actual doll. The point of it is to implant the idea into children's head when they are young that someone is always watching them. That I feel physically healthier if I could get my anxiety under control. Stress will frick up your body. Random Shuffle on Windows Media Player isn't actually random. Out of all the songs I have, I feel like I get a few specific ones at the beginning pretty much every time I load the playlist. While there are other songs that I even forgot I already have because they never play. If there are people who will pick their nose and eat their boogers, there are people who will wipe their butts and lick their poo. I guarantee it. We just can't spot these suckers because doing the number two is always done in private. But they are out there. I'm damn certain of it. Small slash lack of pockets in women's clothing is a thing so that fashion companies can sell more purses. Also, Brad Pitt just dates female clones of himself. Facial features aren't unique. They can be repeated like lips is the same feature for one in every 200,000. My father-in-law got up in the middle of the night and finished off the birthday cake. I believe that if you separated the population of any country or city based on either religion, skin color, gender, age group, economical class, political affiliation or eye color, you would find the same percentage of assholes in each of those subgroups. That there are single women in my area waiting to date me. That if someone else lived the exact life and circumstances that I did, they would have done a better job than me. That my generation, M25 yo, will bear witness to a cataclysmic event that dramatically restructures the geopolitical system and society as we know it. I'm talking an event on par with the Great Depression or WWII, perhaps even the fall of Rome or the plague. I feel it is just about time for the wave to crash. HQ is a scam, somehow. They're somehow mining data from us, and they're cheating us somehow. We are living in an alternate evil reality, because somebody time traveled and messed everything up. I believe that E equals MC2, but I can't prove it, because I'm too dumb. In the 90s, business leaders all bought stock in student loan companies and began demanding pays for entry slash middle level jobs. North Dakota is a hoax. That the vacuum shop down the street is a money laundering operation. Never a customer in the store. No new inventory since what looks like the late 90s to early aughts. And yet, they've been open for business since the 1950s. A specialized vacuum shop could never survive in this Walmart era. There's just no way. Also mattress firm. Same deal. I just know it. Some employers make having a driver's license a requirement for jobs that clearly wouldn't need to involve driving, because it's a legal way to discriminate against disabled applicants. FASA book suggested friend algorithm is partly based on people that have stalked you. Most, or, animals are much more intelligent than researchers give them credit for. I can see a thinking creature if I watch any of them long enough. Praying mantises especially. That ancient civilizations were way more advanced than we give them credit for. This line of thinking can go a few different ways. Some more ridiculous than others, but I think as a baseline it is true. That Jeff Bezos is laughing at all of us not realizing that the Amazon arrow is really a bean. For a brief window of time following the Second World War, the United States could have taken over the world. Every other industrialized economy in the world was in ruins or exhausted from fighting. We were the only nation in the world that knew how to construct the atomic bomb. If that advantage had been pressed and the bomb used without restraint, the US might have been able to overwhelm the Soviet Union before it developed nuclear capabilities of its own. The result would have been a dystopian nightmare worse than anything the Nazis could have imagined. A single nuclear weapon state enforcing a global hegemony through the threat of nuclear war. All of this is wild. Braindead speculation, of course. More like 65%. But, the Hawaiian missile false alarm was intended to see how a large group would respond knowing they are about to die. I believe bad luck exists to steer us in the right direction. For example, turning around because I forgot my wallet to find I'd left the front door open. That's why I'm not so upset about having to cancel a recent vacation. I had vehicle breakdowns, one after another, on a road trip, had to cancel after only 200 miles and go home. Maybe something horrible would have happened out in the desert if I'd continued. The funeral home by my house is run by some sort of criminal organization. I always see the same gangster-looking guys hanging out in front of it smoking cigars and drinking drinks. Mattress firm is a money laundering front. There are at least four within my small city's limits. No one buys that many mattresses. When you look at a person completely unaware of you, they have the impulse to turn and look at you too. Everyone on Reddit is a bot except me. The timers at McDonald's to determine when the fries are done frying move at a rate of 2 units per second in order to make employees feel like they are moving too slow and to work faster. Giant creatures exist in the deepest parts of the sea. That the Nutella recipe has changed markedly over the last 10, 15 years, and not just the most recent highly publicized change. I now find the texture in particular to be almost gross, whereas I used to enjoy guzzling it in large quantities. I've noticed a few way overpriced gas stations in LA, and at first I thought it was because they were off the highway or something, and catching people who weren't locals and didn't know any better. But then I noticed they're next to police stations, and have completely convinced myself that they jack up the price because, I assume, the gas money to fill up the police fleet comes from the government and not individual officers. So nobody cares. The person I have a crush on has a crush on me. There is an infinite number of universes. I've waited a long time to be asked this exact question. 1. Skittles are all the same flavor. 2. Quail can only fly like 20 feet at a time. They can't hold sustained flight. 3. When Mormons get married, they are issued a secret sex how-to pamphlet because they've had such sheltered lives up until then. Nobody can convince me otherwise. 30 years ago or so, it was the oil companies behind Save the Trees to get everybody to use more plastic. Plastic bags, plastic straws, all sorts of stuff. Nobody was cutting down the rainforest to make paper grocery bags. Trees, paper trees especially, are a crop like any other. Save the wheats. Don't eat bread. Signed, con farmers. That be weird, right? After 36 years, my dad is still on his way back from getting cigarettes. The Denver airport has a doomsday bunker built beneath it for important people like the president, who was Obama at the time. Talent shows on TV plant the people who they audition, and the judges are cued to ask questions based on their stories. Kennedy shot first. Lindbergh killed his own child and then set up the whole kidnapping thing to cover his ass. That time is cyclical slash that there are multiple dimensions and universes. There is a gremlin in my dryer that steals my socks. If we were to able to zoom in far enough at a microscopic level, quarks and stuff are self-contained universes. Likewise, if we were to zoom out, our universe is just a quark in some grander scheme. I'm Romanian and I'm not sure if it's the culture or the place I grew up in, but whenever you lose something and are panicking to find it, there's a simple way to always find it. Just go get a mug and visualize a smaller version of the object you're looking for. I do it so it's kind of spinning like a video game. After seeing it in the can, flip over the can on the table and leave the object covered by the flip mug on the table. Stop looking for the object. You will find it in your hands in less than 2 days. No matter what, if it's something like your keys or wallet or socks or headphones, you will 100% come across them, maybe even minutes after doing it. So long as you just avoid thinking of it. I'm not superstitious at all, and I understand that this can be explained just by the way we interact with the things around us in our day-to-day lives. But after growing up with this and it never faltering even on big things, I simply feel better off pleading ignorance and understanding that some things are just going to be how they are, and putting time into thinking about them is a waste of my time. Also, my mom is a luck magnet and a telepath and a wizard, but that's a story for another day. Religion is a scam. Financial systems are involved in a conspiracy to remove financial education from public schools. This is in order to keep young people financially illiterate and more susceptible to incurring debt. They influence governments to remove or fail to include mandatory financial learning from standard curricula. Seriously, I never learned anything about the financial reality that I would face as a citizen of my country. I did a brief 3-month elective rotation at age 14 learning how to write a budget sheet and how businesses worked, but nothing about my personal financial rights and responsibilities. I second aliens. There are trillions of them. None have visited Earth, but they're out there. The fasten seatbelt sign could have been turned off a while ago technically, but the flight attendants don't want people in their way. This thread should be titled, Things That Will Give You Anxiety From Now On Every Time You Think About It. There's only one property, brother. They edit the other one in, and that's why you see them together so little. They do minor changes to make you think they don't look alike, but I know there's only one. You can't fool me, HGTV NTLC. That a car's combination meter is also a secret timer that, when its clock runs out, starts messing with the electrical systems, turning on warning lights, and sending you back to the dealer for expensive diagnostics and unnecessary replacement parts. That there is no afterlife. Time travel is real, but it isn't what we think. That's just our name for a concept our limited human brains can't understand. That vaping is unhealthy. That crap just can't be good for your lungs. I think Maddie McCann's parents killed her. That sandwiches taste 100x is better when cut diagonally. I saw a witch in flight for a terrifying moment. I'm still haunted from this sight 17 years later. That imaginary friends are real and there is some kind of secret society somewhere. I still vividly remember my imaginary friend and it kind of creeps me out that I can recall moments of him being very tangible and not very imaginary. P equals NP. Late to the party, but I believe that infants, toddlers, and young children have emotions, thoughts and feelings, just as rich and complex as adults, if not more, so due to the magnitude of each new discovery. Tom Cruise is a great actor, that seems like a decent person despite being a Scientologist, so the obvious conclusion is, that he's using his acting skills to go undercover, and attempting to dismantle Scientology from the inside. That there are mountain lions in Perry County, PA. The government knows more about the Vegas shooting, and covered it up. Ghosts slash spirits slash entities slash phantoms slash presences. Whatever you want to call it slash them. They say seeing is believing. And in this case, it's absolutely true. Very few things, if anything at all, compares to the feeling of knowing something else exists, and having not only no proof, but this whole new level of fear that comes with life itself. That very few people can relate to you about. Seeing things that shouldn't be is frightening enough. But imagine being alone and that. No one else but a dog is witness. You can talk to him. But he won't reply. You can't convince yourself you were just tired, sick, crazy. It was real. Whatever it was. And there's no one to explain how or why. Humpty Dumpty was not an egg. There's nothing to prove he was. But he did seem to have a shell. Cell phones are freaking up an entire generation of children. That humans have to be, by some degree, psychic or able to tell the future somehow. Think about it. How many times have you thought of a song in your head, right before it comes on the radio? Or had a topic in mind and came across other people discussing it? Or thought of something at the same time as someone else? That stuff happens too often for it to just be chance. That we are going to develop an artificial superintelligence at some point within the next 50 years. And this will be the single most significant invention in the history of mankind. Also, it might not be a good thing for the vast majority of the population. It will be somewhere on the scale of very, very bad to very, very good. I don't think we will know where it will be on this scale until we have invented it. That around 12,13,000 years ago there was a global catastrophe due to a large-scale impact on the Earth's surface that reset human civilization back to a stone age era of technology. Didn't believe this for the longest time, but the evidence is overwhelming. Everywhere from Egypt to Peru there are megalithic structures that share the exact same tool marks and building techniques. Laser cutting precision. Perfect drill holes through solid granite, which is nearly impossible with suggested copper tools of modern archaeology. Stone walls that are built with no mortar, and instead with interlocking stone. 90 degree angles cut, machined, to 1/10,000 of an inch, only capable nowadays with computers and modern machining. There was a global advanced civilization before us, that was erased over time. The only remnants of this civilization are the stone structures they left behind that are over-engineered to a level that, without computers and machines, exceeds modern capability. Overall, I highly recommend looking into this. It's fascinating. Also, there are others who do a much better job at explaining this than I do. Brian Forrester is a great source. Look him up on YouTube. That the US military possesses many technological advancements, but it is all kept secret, so that other countries can't use them. Free will doesn't actually exist, it's an illusion, based on the unidirectional nature of causality. We can know the past, but only approximately predict the future. Why did you read this post? Because you wanted to. Why did you want to? Because you have a predisposed interest in the subject matter. Why do you have a predisposed interest in the subject matter? Because the last time you read things on Reddit, they made you happy. Why do you like being happy? Cause it feels good. Why does being happy feel good? Brain chemistry. Why brain chemistry? That's just how the universe evolved. This far down, you have no control over it. If your brain chemistry was just slightly different, say you were raised in a different environment or a mutation occurred that made reading less interesting for you, then you wouldn't have read this comment. But you did read it. By the anthropic principle, the universe must have evolved to such a state that you end up reading this post. And since there's nothing to suggest the universe will change its course of evolution anytime soon, there's also nothing suggesting you won't continue reading more Reddit posts. You don't actually have a choice in anything you do. You were going to do it before you even realized. The US government conspired to have MLK assassinated. That my girlfriend is never truly mad at me. She just likes to see how I handle her bullcrap. James Bond isn't a singular man, but an alias given to whomever assumes the role in MI5. That's the only thing that could explain him spanning multiple decades and not progressing in age. Whoever started the flat earth conspiracy theory doesn't actually believe it. They did it as a massive troll for their own amusement of watching dumb people dedicate themselves to something so stupid. There's a secret society of the 5 wealthiest people in the world, known as the Pentaveret, the Queen, the Vatican, the Jetties, the Rothschilds, and Colonel Sanders, before he went tits up, who run everything in the world including the newspapers, and meet triannually in a secret country mansion in Colorado, known as the Meadows. Who I hated the Colonel, with his wee beady eyes, and that smug look on his face. Oh, you're gonna buy me chicken? He put an addictive chemical in his chicken, that makes you crave it fortnightly. Governments collude all the time, and pretend to be shocked if found out. There is a somewhat universal, not every country participates, ruling class that has chopped up the world like Europe did Africa. And they work together to keep the structure intact. That US taxes are a giant scam, and there's an obscene amount of money that's not accounted for going into the pockets of a select group of assholes. The picture books were definitely spelled as the Bernstein Bears with an E. Never was it spelled the Bernstein Bears with an R. My brother-in-law is absolutely doing heroin and hiding it from his entire family and girlfriend. I'm convinced Botox rots your brain. The spiritual realm. I've had some very strange experiences after meditation. Women's clothing does not typically have pockets in order to increase handbag sales. When a woman find any item of clothing with decent pockets, especially dresses, my god, they will let you know. I once spent a whole day looking for a pair of work pants that would simply hold my phone and a box cutter. I went to the largest shopping mall in my state. Could not find anything for less than $100. My work is pretty taxing on clothes, so I'm not spending that kind of money on something that's just going to fall apart. Went away empty-handed. Whenever I talk about this, the response is why not get a bag? Doesn't fit in with my work, and B, frick buying an extra product when I shouldn't have to. I've now switched to men's clothing and have pants that are just as slim-fitting but have functional pockets. I now have no trouble finding cheap pants that not only fit, I'm not curvy, and have a boyish build. Most 20th folks cannot do this, but have pockets that fit everything I need. Frick the pocketriarchy. Subway sandwiches used to taste good. Now they taste like bad meat and bad bread. Gravity. I believe if I drop a thing it will fall to the ground. Tiger Woods lifted too many weights, got huge and buff. And that's why the last decade of his career suffered, and why he had back problems in the first place. The lack of flexibility and tightening of his back muscles affected his swing to the point where control became a major issue. All this because he was addicted to pussy more than golf. and preferred to look the stud in the bedroom over anything else. Nowadays he has tried hard to rebound, lost a lot of his body mass, looks leaner and is suddenly winning again. It's obvious, but no one talks about it. Sex addiction played into his self-image, which impacted his physical ability to perform on a professional level for the good part of a decade. The Truman Show is a documentary based off my life, and I know everything I write here will be broadcasted. They do not have my consent to keep me here. A lot of people walking around are just NPCs, non-playable characters. That is why they are programmed so easily. Not even Trump believes half the crazy crap Pence says. He just elected Pence as a VP, so nobody would try assassinating him.